just a shame. It's a drag, it's a wound, it's a saw, it's just insane. It's a stain, a decay, it's a crack, it's a disgrace. Evil wind, bloody day, it's a slap in our face. It's a crying, crying shame. What a shame, unbelieving, evil days. Oh, what a pain. It's a struggle, a struggle of power and fame. Oh, the helpless ones who will die, who is to blame? It's a game, how to play. It's a win, it is a lose. It's a chain, so much pain. Oh, please bring your fighting shoes. It's a cheese, it's a tussle, it's a war.
That there was an attack earlier this morning on the state party chairman.
Yes, that's correct.
And how is he now, sir?
Unfortunately, we lost him.
But sir, was there any account by an eyewitness?
The driver survived it, and he has told us the experiences, and police are working on it.
But sir,
the party chairman is supposed to have a security early.
Yes, actually he has, but the poor man was the first target, and I must say he died on the spot.
Oh, sorry. Your Excellency, sir. Are there any suspects?
There are none for now, but I think that question shouldn't be for us.
Exactly.
It should be directed to the police. Thank you very much.
Ah, Professor, it's getting late.
Are you scared? With your battalion of aides attaches and what have you?
Ah, Prof, don't be sarcastic. I only have two police security men. That is Inspector Davis and the other boy. The other two agents are arrangements made by me.
Okay, that's Austin and his colleague, right?
Oh, yes, Austin. You know him?
Sure, we know Austin very well. Austin was very supportive during our last campaign trip.
Oh, oh yes, he's a very, very nice boy.
Yes.
So what did you say you wanted to tell me?
It's about this auditing directed from the presidency. I want you to skip my ministry.
Skip your ministry?
Yes, it is possible. After all, this is our country and we are in the corridors of power. Otumba, I want you to name your prize.
Prize? What prize?
I don't know, but you know, you are a politician.
Look, I don't understand this game. Just come straight. What do you want from me?
All right, I'll come out straight. I want you to know that this auditing directed from the presidency by the vice president was meant to witch hunt people like you and I. And this one particularly was packaged by the vice president to nail me.
Nail you?
Yes.
Why should you be a clause in this machination?
Because he knows that I'm in the forefront of the campaign to ensure that come next election, the president does not choose him as a VP.
And why?
I am not the only one. Most of our colleagues agree that the VP is very high-handed, and therefore we should make sure that it's flushed out.
Let us not deviate. What were you saying?
Yes, that this auditing at my ministry is not ready for it now.
Yeah, but your ministry got funds from us and you have to follow the directives as directed.
Yes, we did. And that is one of the major reasons why the vice president is witch hunting me, because I don't know, but perhaps some people have gone to inform him that I planned to transfer the funds to a foreign account.
You what? You want to divert an international grant? You want to close down our probability of for foreign grants? You? Have you no atom of patriotism, Professor? Oh, so you have suddenly lost your ethics as a medical professor just because you joined politics? How can you? How can you divert money made to salvage the plight of people who are dying of the scourge of AIDS into your own private account? How? Are you out of your mind?
Otumba Lambert, Dami Joe, I want you to realize that you are in my house.
So what? So what? You traitor! You traitor of a health minister! Look, come tomorrow morning. I am going to inform the authorities.
Otumba Dami Joe, you don't mean you want to probe me?
You listen, I am not mincing words. I will stick to my promise. I will not fail. You!
What about that, Nito? Forget it. This is our country.
I want you to draft a report to the Inspector General of Police and the Auditor General, informing them of the Ministry of Health's refusal to adhere to the presidency's directive that all accounts should be rendered to our ministry. And also, the Minister of Health's intention to transfer $500 million into a foreign account. These and other subscribing matters I want you to add in this draft. Send me a copy as soon as you finish. Yes? Hello, Mrs. Williams. How are you? Bad news? No, I've not heard. What? When? The party chairman dead? Oh my God. The governor? Oh, he was attacked? Oh, not very seriously. Okay. Oh my God. Oh, thank you. This is serious. Is the security of the state so bad now? Oh my God.
This is a cruel mismatch of justice. A total misjudgment of complaints.
No, leave them.
Leave them. Let them be. Let them go ahead and suspend me.
Suspension is not death.
Neither is the National Executive Council God. Let them go ahead and suspend me. But it's quite crystal clear that UCP is just one out of 28 political parties. So let them go ahead and suspend me.
I know this is all Otumba's handiwork.
I don't care whose handiwork it is anymore. I don't care who's responsible anymore. But what I know is that they have met a man who is their match. Games. Monkey games.
I too do no longer care. Adejuba suspended me. Where is he today?
Eternal suspension.
Well, let him figure that one out with his own spirit. All I've said is that I will never be part of any form of brutality.
And all I am saying is that I am equal to the task. You suspend me, God will suspend you.
Yes.
That's my own ideology.
Yes.
If Otumba thinks he's invincible, I will prove to him that he's as vulnerable as an antelope without legs. I hear he's coming back this night for the chairman's burial. He's coming back for his own funeral. Every time, impeach the deputy governor. Remove him. Kill him. Am I a problem of the state?
Well, as you people can see, because of the insecurity in the state, I brought in all those police guards and different security agents. Just last night, I received a threatening call in Abuja warning me that if I loved my life, I should not step into this state today. I have shoved it aside, believing that it could be all about Desmond and his miscreants.
Oh. But Chief, this is serious. Very serious. You should have alerted the police about the threat.
I am loaded to the hilt with policemen, with police security guards. Anyway, I am loaded to the hilt with security operatives, and they can avert any danger. How about the governor, Speaker?
Well, Chief, he gets better every day, and I'm sure he'll be fit for the bearer tomorrow.
I understand that you are deputizing in his capacity.
Yes, Chief, you're right.
So, what about your security arrangements?
Anyway, Chief, they are not unaware of the task, so we took proper consideration of that. And the police commissioner promised to send down 50 mobile policemen for the bearer, and also 10 patrol teams to be on guard throughout the ceremony.
So at least our security is guaranteed.
This opportunity once again to introduce two noble men that are standing in our midst. First is the acting secretary of our party in the state since the suspension of Kemi Nelson by the state party ESCO. He is Barrister Olajide Gayos. He is now the chairman of the party. Thank you very much. Please sit down.
Thank you.
The other gentleman is Badmus Olabode, the new secretary of our party in the state.
Please.
Your Excellency the Governor.
Thank you very much, sir.
UCP!
Power to the people.
First of all, I want to congratulate both of you for your new appointment. I wish you well, and I believe that both of you will carry our great party to greater heights. You are welcome on board.
Major, I have come for you.
Who let you in here? You have been suspended from this party and you have no reason barging into our meeting.
This one, who brought you here?
Shut up!
You are disrupting our gentle proceedings. Please!
Sit down there. Don't ever talk to me that way.
Oh, what will you do, Desmond? I said, what can you do if I talk to you like that? You're a punk.
Mrs. William, please stop that.
You call me a punk?
Yes.
Yes, I'm a bad punk. And I'm going to teach you what a punk does.
No. Desmond, please get out of this place. Please.
And you, Otumba, chief or whatever you call yourself, the battle has just begun. You will never live to see this race you began to a finish.
To think that I was your political godfather. You are a big disappointment.
Good luck.
Let's see how this hate is going to be absorbed by all of us.
Just get out.
Have a nice meeting, everybody.
I don't want to see anybody today again.
The president is not here because of his dead shadow. Prof.
Yes, Mr. Chairman.
Can you please tell us why you decided to call this emergency meeting?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
DPP Progress!
DPP
Progress!
DPP
Progress!
Thank you, very loyal party members. I called all of us here today so that we can rub minds and see clearly the possibility of our president losing come next election.
God forbid such mishap.
Yes. Mr. Chairman, I would love to say the same prayer with you and then sit back, but it is not possible. You know why? Because if the president loses, we all have lost.
Yes.
Yes. We are one fraternity. It behoves all of us to champion the success of each other.
Well, Prof, I still cannot read where you're heading to.
I love you, man. You are the advisor on political matters to the vice president.
Yes.
I am the Minister for Health. But aside from the ministry that I head, you know who I am in this party. I am talking about the purported intention of Otumba Damijo to run for presidency on the ticket of UCP, his aboriginal party.
That intention, as much as I know, is certain.
Well, it's a plain reality because he has invited the vice president and has intimated him on that.
You see? You see, so what do we do?
That is awesome.
Awesome? is a harbinger of doom. Yes, we all know that Otumba Damijo comes from the same area with the vice president. And it was solely because of the vice president that our party was able to win some votes in that area.
Yes, yes, of course.
Yes, and if he dares to run, that means we'll lose from that region again.
Sure. Yes. And that was why he was inculcated into the cabinet in the first place. So that UCP could be polarized, whereas we take a ride into that region.
Ladies and gentlemen, something alarming is about to happen.
Very alarming, because Mr. President already has opponents from his own region and other regions too.
And now the VP's region is about to be lost to UCP on Otumba's calculation.
So,
something must be done.
And very promptly too. Yes, I suggest he should leave us completely.
Yes, let him go. Go.
Let him leave us.
Good. Are we all in agreement with that?
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Good. Let's think we have agreed on that.
Yes.
I thank you very much. I want to introduce Lady Franca to you all. Lady Franca is my lady. But you see, she works as a confidential secretary in the office of Otumba Damijo. There's no secret whatsoever in that office that she cannot bring that for us.
Oh, that's good.
Wow. That's why she's one of us.
BBB!
Progress!
BBB!
Progress!
BBB!
Super Progress!
Thank you.
Madam, yes. I hope you're with us.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
I wouldn't let
you down. Thank you very much, madam.
Thank you very much. Hello? Ah, Omolara. Oh, it's nice to hear from you. How is your brother? Oh, that is fine. And your program? Oh, you are finished. So you now have your master's. That is wonderful. Actually, I am just coming in and I'm a little bit tired. Oh, congratulations, my darling. Yes, I owe you one. Well done. Well done. So, when are you coming back? Ah, so soon? No. Ah, of course, I want you around. You know, the elections are coming up again and your father has been asked to vie for post of the presidency. No. I am a member, a minister in the party. Yes. Yes. No, our party is good except for some security matters that are affecting the state at the moment. The state, the party chairman was assassinated. Yeah, we don't know yet, but the governor survived the attack. Oh yes, no. I'm not taking anything for chances. The whole compound is packed full with mobile police men. Thank you, my dear. I appreciate that. Yes. But one thing, when you want to come back, just let us know so that we can make all arrangements for you. Okay, darling. No, I am not taking anything for granted. The compound is packed full with mobile police men. Of course. No. I don't take chances.
Thank you, my darling.
Thank you. Don't forget to get in touch when you're coming, man. Love you. Bye-bye.
Austin!
Austin!
Sir.
I want you to come with me upstairs. I have something I want you to do for me.
Lion to Hector. Lion receives signal loud and clear. Yes, sir. Order received loud and clear. Over and out. Area! There is an order that all of you should be deployed to the late chairman's house. So, get on with it. Move it. Move it.
Come here, sir.
I want you to make 20 copies of this. Go down to my study and make photocopies of it. Okay? It is top secret. Okay?
Everything in place?
Everything is under control. No crime, sir.
Sure?
No problem, sir.
Alright, get going. I want results.
Trust me.
Where are your boys?
They've all gone for emergency response.
Emergency response?
Yes. There is this order that I should deploy all of them to the late chairman's house.
For what, for God's sake? This whole place is empty. Dixon!
Yes, I'm here.
Inspector?
Yes.
Who gave the orders?
The order is from headquarters.
Well, that concerns you. I'm going out.
Excuse me, where are you heading? As you can see, we don't have enough men to guard this place.
But I'm going out, there's no way I'm going to come back. Let me look for something to eat.
Something to eat?
Are the cooks not on duty?
I wonder.
I want to eat a very good food.
Okay, make sure you come back immediately, right?
Sorry. Let me have the keys.
Oh, sure. Here.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Here is OCTV News in brief at noon. I am Lydia Macaulay. It has been confirmed that the Honorable Minister for Finance, Otumba Lamba Damijo, has finally taken his last breath at Federal Teaching Hospital, where he was admitted after yesterday night's attack on him at his residence by unidentified gunmen. According to the medical officer in charge of the hospital, the minister died at about 5:45 a.m. this morning.
The deed is done, Honorable Minister.
Among the various positions held by the late minister in his lifetime, he served as a director of finance in the State Ministry for Finance between 1976 to 1979, and he also served as the commissioner for chieftaincy affairs and local government matters during his time. And now, sports news.
Oh, it's quite unfortunate.
Too bad for such personality. May soul rest in the Lord.
Amen.
It's quite a shame. Blood day.
In the dark, in the moon, it's a war. It's just a shame. It's a drag. It's a wound, it's a sore, it's just insane. It's a stain, a decay, it's a crack, it's a disgrace. Evil wind, bloody day, it's a slap in our face. It's a crying, crying shame. What a shame, unbelieving. Evil days, oh what a pain. It's a struggle of power and fame. Oh the helpless ones who will die, who is to blame. It's a game, how to play. It's a win, it is a lose. It's a chain, so much pain.
Ma'am, this is brutal. This is inhuman. God, I can't believe this. I can't believe that this kind of politics could still be played in this part of the world at this time and age with so much rancor and brutality. If the minister of the Federal Republic could be cheaply assassinated in nowhere else but right inside his bedroom in his house, then we all have to go to the rocks for a hide because the society ain't safe for any of us. Your Excellency, this is barbaric.
It's gruesome, Omolara. It's so pathetic and derogatory of our security system in this part of the world.
What is the federal government doing about this?
Well, Mr. President just finished the emergency security council meeting and instructed the police and the SSS to work together and fish out the perpetrators of this heinous crime within 6 months.
6 months? No! I can't take this! Gosh! What's happening to this country? You mean my father was arrogantly assassinated and the FG relapses on investigation for as long as 6 months?
Well, on our own lady, the police command has intensified such an investigation with the arrest of your father's security men, Sergeant Austin and Dixon.
And what are they saying?
Well, we just turned them in. I will assign the most reputable detective to the investigation tomorrow morning. He was on leave, but he resumed tomorrow as well.
Omolara, my dear. Please, accept my deep sympathy.
Thank you.
It's a pity, Omolara. Please, take heart, okay?
Thank you.
Accept my condolences. And let me reassure you of my government resolve to get to the bottom of this matter. And by his grace, we must surely succeed.
I must appreciate your excellency. I need a partnership, okay? And I'm gonna take on it too. But whoever I find responsible, I'm gonna use all the knowledge in the law within my disposal to make sure the bastard suffers to the brain. That and I can assure you. That I can assure you.
On behalf of the police command, I am assuring you of our total support to your own personal stride and on revealing your father's killer. As much as I know, it won't be too long for the police to track them down.
Well, Amalara, we have had our day and we must leave now.
You have been coping with your lessons now.
Yes.
So are you having any problem in any of the subjects?
No, Dad.
Are you having problem with your lesson teacher?
No.
So how come you have this wound? Are you proving stubborn in your class?
No.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Tell that, are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure.
Bruno, I have to go to work now. I have an urgent call.
But Daddy, you said you'll leave. How come you are going back to duty?
Bruno, I have to, okay? Duty calls.
Duty calls all the time.
Not all the time, boy. But this time around, most sensitive. The commissioner himself wants to see me.
I don't just like this rejection, Daddy. It will make me so lonely.
You are not going to be lonely. You are not going to be lonely. Because I always come around to pick and drop you at home after your lessons.
Home?
Yes.
Home is boring too. Since mother died, I hate staying at home alone.
Come on, Bruno. Don't trail into recalls. Leave the dead to stay away.
But the memory is dead. It keeps coming.
I know. You see, Bruno, don't give me any gloomy moments. You need to be happy. And I too. So put the memories away. Bruno, Daddy loves you. And I will do anything to keep you happy. I promise. I will always come around to pick and drop you at home after your lessons. Or I'll send any of my junior officers whenever I'm busy. Okay? Good. So you have to cope with Ekaite in the house. Like I told you, she's a nice person. Until I am able to get you a stepmother.
Dad, you will?
Yes, I will. I will do anything for you. Okay? So you have to cope with your lessons. Now? Alright?
Okay.
With heart. If I'm coming back, I'll buy you ice cream and meat pie.
Okay, Daddy.
Okay.
Bye.
Sean, sir.
Thank you, Godwin. You are welcome. Sit down.
Thank you, sir. Godwin.
Sir, you must have heard about the assassination of the minister.
Yes, sir. I heard it as I just flew into the country. But I learned that the investigations on it are federally prosecuted.
Yes. You are right in a way. The federal government set joint investigation team of the police and the SSS. But our command is on special mandate to work on the case for the first 1 month out of 6 months allowed for the investigation. So that calls for our consent. Meanwhile, we have in our custody two SS agents and the mobile guards in the minister's security cell the very night he was shot. So you got to go on duty, detective.
Yes, sir. Sean, sir.
You're welcome.
Agent, I'll order my boys to butter you over and out.
I swear that's the much that I know, sir. Believe me, I swear to God, that's the much that I know.
Now, do you know we are talking about a serving minister of the Federal Republic assassinated? Not any time, but when you are on his guard. Not anywhere, but where you are supposed to guard 24 hours times 7 and over. You see, don't let me lose the grip of my SPD call.
Sir, believe me, we were not expecting that attack. We were taken on our ways.
Hold it! Just hold it right there.
That I know, believe me. I swear to God, believe me.
It's okay. I got the whole story of what happened on that fateful night. So, I wouldn't want us to recall, unless you have something else to tell me.
No, sir.
Well, since you don't, I have just one to tell you. You're a first man, and you know what it means. Saying that a job is sensitive or delicate. But Austin, you surprise me. You amaze me by your attitude to duty on that fateful night. So what informed your leave from your duty post just a few minutes before your subject was attacked?
I left to eat.
Eat? Don't tell me that the late minister was as naive as not to have an ordinary cook in his residence. Are you gonna tell me that?
I decided to have a change of diet.
Wonderful decision! But how do you explain that it was only on the night the minister was attacked and killed that you developed this sudden drive to have a change of diet?
It was a coincidence, sir.
Coincidence?
Yes, sir.
Good coincidence. But I bet you, Austin, you will never want us to coincide here. Or do you?
No, sir.
Now listen to me. If there is anything you're not telling me about this case, begin to say it right now. Because you're about to face the drum of a very deadly music.
There's nothing more I have to say, sir.
Answer, tell me!
There's nothing more I have to say, sir. I'm not serious now.
Officer! Take this monk out here!
The Federal Executive Council has this afternoon approved the appointment of Mrs. Olufemi Balde as the new Minister for Finance. She replaces Otumba Lambert Akindamijo, who was assassinated a fortnight ago at his hometown. Mrs. Balde's appointment takes effect from today, the 24th of August. Meanwhile, investigations are still on over the brutal assassination of the late Minister for Finance. A joint team of the police and SSS in charge of the murder says they have a lead into the murder and shall unravel the killers in no distant time.
That'll be enough for now.
Let us see how they will unravel this and find the killers. Sherlock Holmes.
We are very close to the late minister before he died.
That's correct.
And because I buy his ideals and policies in this ministry before his death, I would want to work with both of you in a most cordial manner.
Okay.
I want both of you to lend me your hands to carry on with the good policies and diligence of service which he bequeathed to us.
That's okay, madam. We've been there for the late chief and we promise to be there as well for you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Secretary.
Yes, madam.
I want to see all the correspondences of the minister.
Okay.
Auditor. Please forward to me all the late minister's expenditure reports and prior directive to your office before he died.
Yes, madam.
Thank you very much. Lady and gentlemen, it's been a nice day.
Once again, you're very welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you, madam.
Have a good day.
Thank you, madam.
Hello, good evening.
Yeah, good evening, Gordon. How are you?
Fine, thank you. Who is this, please?
Well, a friend.
A friend? Sorry, but I can't guess who.
Don't worry. You don't need to know who.
Well, if you say so, what do you want from me, friend?
Just a little favor. Coming in with some goody-goody. Well, it has run into 3 days since you took charge of investigation over Otumba's murder.
Very correct, friend.
Good. I want you to name to us how much it can cost to facilitate the escape of one of the security detainees in your custody over the murder.
Who out of them?
Your price first.
Excuse me, who are you, please?
It still won't matter, detective.
Well, it's impossible. And besides, I don't do a thing like that.
Well, wise answer. But not fantastic anyway. What happens if you are forced to do so, detective?
Not until I am forced to.
Thank you very much. You'll hear from me.
Good day.
I am Bimbo Donnell from the SSS. I have another from the State Commandant to come and pick two of our colleagues that are involved in the incident to the headquarters for questioning.
You're welcome, Agent Daniel.
Thank you very much.
Oh, Who authorized this?
The Commandant General.
Is my commissioner aware of it?
Well, I don't know.
Then you need also to obtain an authorization from the commissioner as well.
I don't think so, detective. I have my order.
But as you can see, agent, I'm not a subject to this order.
So?
So I can't obey it.
All right. Good day, detective.
Good day, agent.
Feeling today?
I'm fine, thank you.
I'm Sergeant Sly, your dad's colleague in the office. He sent me down here to pick you up.
Pick me up?
Yeah.
It just gone past 5.
Yeah, I know, Bruno, but you see, there's a little trouble in the office. In fact, there's a threat to your dad by someone about you. In fact, you really have to act fast. You see, you really have to go now, boy.
I can't go with you, I don't know you.
Oh, I complained about this to your dad, okay? But he said I should come, and he gave me this picture of yours. Just come close and have a look at this. Come on, boy. We just have to go now. We just have to go now.
It's okay, huh?
Everything's gonna be alright. That's my boy.
So, sir, there was an order to that effect. And if we are able to track down the officer who gave the late inspector the go-ahead order to deploy the police guards, it will really give us a lead.
How do you intend to go about it?
Street interrogations of all the officers within the premises of this headquarters at about the hours of 6 to 10 p.m. on that fateful Saturday night. And most especially, all the senior officers of the rank of inspector. Because someone who could command Inspector Davis to such a misdemeanor must be an officer above his rank.
Charles,
sir. Commander. Yeah, my commander.
How are you?
Charles, Miss Damijo, please sit down.
Thank you.
How far have you gone about Michael?
Oh, pretty well. Well on it, sir. The culprits are still at large, but we hope to cash in on them pretty soon.
Good promise.
Pretty soon.
I was about to say that the murder case of the State Party Chairman has lingered so long. Ms. Damijo. Welcome once again.
Thank you.
This is the detective, Godwin. He's working on your father's murder case investigation.
It's my pleasure, detective.
Pleasure is mine. You're welcome.
Thank you.
There is a development lately. Detective has been complaining of series of threat calls and sort of dangerous calls and dangerous movements around his office lately.
Threat calls?
Yes. So many threat calls. Who is this?
Yeah, same old friend, detective.
Yes, what can I do for you?
How will you feel when you'll be left with no choice as to facilitate the release of our ward, detective?
Old friend, not until I'm left with no choice. But unfortunate to you,
I'll always have a choice.
Hold it there, friend. You lie. Because when such a handsome little boy as Bruno is the stake, you'll be left with no choice. Thank you.
Bruno.
Excellency.
What's all this trouble you've been talking about since yesterday? You've been calling me off. What?
Your Excellency. Since after that chase that faithful night by the police, they've been looking around for that car number.
They got your number?
From all indications, sir. Very sorry, sir.
Okay. Stop using that car. I'll send you another one.
Thank you very much, sir.
Good night.
Now listen to me, officer. Officer, listen to me. Listen. I don't want to hear that rubbish anymore. Don't tell me any trash. Are you listening to me? Now, do everything you can to ensure that that boy is released right now. Are you hearing me? Make sure he comes out right now. I am waiting for you to call me that he's out. If not, I will ensure you lose your job.
Hello.
Just hold it, dictator.
Friend, where is my son?
Oh, friend, you sound upset and distressed too.
Please, where is my son? Where is Junior? Where is Bruno?
You play by the rules and you have your son on heart.
Okay. I'm ready. I'm set. What do I do?
Beautiful question. Now listen. First thing tomorrow morning, I want you to visit your boss's office and resign your charge as regards the investigation. Other directives will come after that.
Wait, please hold on. Please, hold on. Please, is there any number I can reach to get onto you?
Don't be so desperate, friend. Catch it cool. And remember, Do not tell one ear about this, or Bruno will die. Our rule used to one: see no evil, hear no evil, talk no evil. I will call you when we need you. Thank you.
Hello, hello, hello. Hello, hello, hello. Hello?
I have critically examined the auditing conducted on other ministers, but I have observed that the health ministry's audit report is omitted. Why the omission?
Madam, it's not as if it was omitted.
But?
There was a sort of non-compliance by the health ministry.
What sort, if I may ask?
Well, the minister bluntly refused to meet up with the auditing exercise.
No. The minister has no business with the report of the accounts of his ministry. It is the accountant who has.
Well, the head ministry's senior accountant said that the minister deals directly with all financial matters, while the auditor himself complained of alienation from the true account of the ministry. So when I complained to Professor Briggs during the auditing exercise, he said he was in no way accountable to me, but to the Auditor General of the Federation.
He said that. Was Otumba aware of this development before he died?
Yes, of course. I reported to him, and consequently, he made a report to the effect.
So what happened?
Well, I don't know, but here I have a copy of the report.
This was supposed to be dispatched many days before Otumba's assassination. Even allegation of the health minister's intention to siphon $500 million grant. My God. This is serious. What was the IG and AGF's reaction to this letter?
Definitely, I don't know. Maybe the personal secretary to the late minister will know better, because her desk is the starting point of the distribution channel here.
Serious? This is serious.
Godwin,
sir. You wish to discontinue?
Yes, sir.
Why?
Nothing, sir. I just wish so.
And you think I will accept so?
Please, sir. Do me this favor. Please, let me go.
Godwin.
Sir.
Tell me exactly what your problem is. Is everything okay with you?
Very perfect, sir. Excellent. Everything is cool. I just need a rest. I just need to be put off just for some weeks.
That is not all you want, Godwin.
Yes, Mama.
Any problem?
No problem, sir. It's just that I came to make a report to the superintendent here, sir.
Yes, Inspector.
Sir, my boss arrested a certain man believed to be a hoodlum.
Yes.
And he's notoriously known as a badass. He was seen the last time driving around Otumba's residence the fateful night he was murdered. And sir, I believe he's the man we'll be looking for.
We got his number then, but now he's arrested, sir. Good. Keep him and wait on me.
Okay, sir.
Godwin. Sir.
You have your request.
Thank you, sir. Sure, sir.
This letter was dated 15th of August.
Yes, ma'am.
Witness, it was drafted 5 days before the minister's assassination.
Yes, ma'am.
So what happened?
I decided not to dispatch the letter yet.
Yet? Yet until what? Oh, you knew the minister was going to die?
No, ma.
No what? Young woman, no what? I said no what? Now listen to me. Look at me very well. Go and ask about me. I do not take nonsense from anything I find myself doing. I think you have a case to answer to the police.
Ah, please, ma, take it easy. It's not what you think.
From my own justification, you are dubious.
No.
That a fraud as weighty as $500 million grant is to be perpetrated and you sat on the alert, it means you intentionally did it and you have to answer to it.
Just a shame, it's a drag, it's a wound, it's a saw, it's just insane, it's a stain, a decay, it's a crack, it's a disgrace, evil wind, bloody day, it's a slap in our face, it's a crying, crying shame. What a shame, unbelieving, evil days. Oh, what a pain. It's a struggle of power and fame. Oh, the helpless ones who will die, who is to blame. It's a game, how to play, it's a win. It is a lose, it's a chain, so much pain. Oh, please bring your fighting shoes. It's a cheese, it's a tussle, it's a world full of mischief. The deceased, it's a rumble, it's a dog without a teeth. It's a crying, crying.